This video demonstrates the difference among several Intel Instrumentation and Tracing Technology APIs, or ITT APIs, including the use of process-based frame APIs compared to the thread-based event and task APIs. While code instrumentation is optional for VTune Profiler analysis, instrumented code can provide enhanced insights into algorithm performance. Examples of use cases that can benefit from instrumentation include analyzing applications performing repeated calculations or analyzing transaction processing on a per-transaction basis to discover the cases that experience bad performance. Frames represent a series of non-overlapping regions of elapsed time between frame begin and endpoints. When frames are displayed in Intel VTune Profiler, they are displayed in a separate track, so they provide a way to visually separate this data from normal task data. Frames are per process and not associated with any specific thread. The Event API is used to observe when events occur in your application or to identify how long it takes to execute regions of code. A task is a logical unit of work performed by a particular thread for a period of time. Tasks typically correspond to functions, scopes, or a case block in a switch statement. First, let's look at the source code implementing these ITT APIs. This is the resource definition and initialization of the domain and events and task strings. Notice that there is no naming for the frame APIs. Also, to help distinguish these later, the event names in this example start with calculate and the task names do not. The task is defined by the bracketing of ITT task begin and ITT task end calls on the same thread. The events and tasks can be used to mark any block of code. In this example, they are used as function wrappers to mark the beginning and end of the function. When event APIs are used with matching event start and event end calls, results are displayed similar to task API calls. When only calling event start without a matching event end, a tick mark is displayed in the timeline view. This example shows the matching event start and event end call behavior. Another difference between using events and tasks is that tasks are associated with a specific ITT domain, while an event is not. The frame begin and frame end APIs can also mark the beginning and end of a code block and are associated with an ITT domain. In this example, it is before and after two calls to the calculation function. Consecutive frame begin calls in the same domain are treated as a frame end followed by a frame begin pair. To demonstrate the difference between thread-specific APIs and process-wide APIs, this example first executes four calculations sequentially, then executes the four calculations in parallel using pthreads. Configure Intel VTune Profiler to run a collection similar to how you normally would. Specify the local or remote host, the application, and the analysis type. When the data collection completes, the Summary tab is activated. This includes the usual summary statistics and top hotspots at the top, CPU utilization histogram in the middle, and the platform information at the bottom. It also includes a table of top tasks and events by count and execution time, and a frame rate histogram showing the duration of the frames with the count of fast and slow frames relative to each other. This histogram shows 5 slow frames and 3 fast frames. The timeline display in the bottom up tab shows the beginning and end of the events and tasks per thread. Mouse hover over those markers to see the event or task name, start time, and duration. Frames are displayed in a dedicated timeline track. Mouse hover over the frame markers to see the count, start time, duration, and fast-slow assessment. In this example, when the child threads execute serially, the frame count increases gradually. When the three child threads execute simultaneously, the frame begin was called 4 times in rapid succession. Consecutive frame begins are treated as a frame end followed by a frame begin, so the frame count rapidly increases from 4 to 8. This is where VTune calculated the 3 fast frames and rated the others as slow. We can zoom in on the timeline view to better see this behavior. Changing the grouping to task domain task type shows some additional differences among these APIs. First, metrics for frames are not displayed in this view. Also observe that the tasks are associated with the domain specified in the application, but the events are system-wide. We have the option to filter in on any of the tasks or events. Change the grouping to frame domain frame duration type frame to see the frames ordered by execution time. Right-click on a frame in this list and select filter in by selection to see the relevant metrics and timeline information for this frame. That makes it easier to identify where to select the timeline range to zoom in. In this case, 4 threads were executing simultaneously, which caused the longest frame duration.